अनुसंधान ऑल गुजरात इंटीग्रेटेड क्लासरूम
सैटेलाइट ना माध्यम थी जोड़ती कड़ी एटले संधान।
वेरी गुड नून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। विकसे विलसे सौनु ज्ञान चालो रचिए सौ संधान। आजनो आज कार्यक्रम छे एटले के सोमवारे 12-1 एने आपणे स्कोप संधान एवुं टाइटल आप्युं छे। एनी पाछळनुं कारण एम छे कि स्कोप रिलेटेड जे कंई न्यूज छे एनी एक्जामिनेशन्स विशेनी माहिती छे ए आपणे आ स्लॉटमांथी करीए छीए, पण साथे साथे वी हेव बीन लकी इनफ टू इन्क्लूड द आईआईटी स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल लेक्चर्स फ्रॉम स्कोप संधान फ्रॉम दिस स्लॉट। अने अगाउ पण बे लेक्चर आपणे जोई चूक्या छीए आ आईआईटी स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल्स बाबतना, एटले के जे फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेर्सनी जे वात करी रह्या छीए आपणे आ स्लॉटना माध्यमथी, અને એ બહુ સરસ રીતે જઈ રહ્યા છે અને બહુ સરસ મજાના ફીડબેક્સ આપના બધા તરફથી અમને મળે છે। વી સિન્સિયરલી થેન્ક યુ ફોર દેટ। આજે ફરીથી આપણી સાથે મિસ્ટર તાદ્રશ શાહ એન્ડ મિસ્ટર નીલ પટેલ આ બંને આપણી સાથે ઉપસ્થિત છે અને આ બંને મિત્રો આપણને આજે વાત કરવાના છે લિનક્સ અને ઉબુન્ટુ વિશે। गया स्लॉट में इफ आई एम नॉट मिस्टेकन यू हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू इंस्टॉल लिनक्स इन योर सिस्टम, बट एट द सेम टाइम हाउ टू यूटिलाइज दैट ए आजनु फोकस रहेशे। पर आई वुड ऑल्सो रिक्वेस्ट तादर्श जी टू गीव अ लिटल हिंट हाउ टू इंस्टॉल इट इन द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द लेक्चर एंड देन यू कैन गो हैड विद द योर रूटीन हाउ टू यूटिलाइज लिनक्स उबुंटू इन योर कम्प्यूटर। मित्रों આપણે આ સ્લોટ જે છે એનું રેકોર્ડિંગ ફરી ફરી બતાવીએ છીએ અને દરેક કોલેજ ઇન્ડિવિડ્યુઅલ લેવલે પણ આ પ્રકારના પ્રોજેક્ટ્સ એક્સેપ્ટ કરી શકે છે અને તાદ્રશજી એમને બહુ હેલ્પફુલ થઈ રહ્યા છે અને સ્કોપ ઇઝ પ્રોવાઇડિંગ જસ્ટ અ મીડિયમ ટુ રીચ ટુ ધ સ્ટુડન્ટ્સ ઓફ ગુજરાત સ્ટેટ। તો આપણે એવું ઈચ્છીએ કે આને સરસ રીતે ઇમ્પ્લિમેન્ટ કરીએ કોલેજ લેવલે પણ, અને જે વિદ્યાર્થીઓ અત્યારે જોઈ રહ્યા છે એ લોકોને પણ આપણે રિક્વેસ્ટ કરીએ કે આ પ્રકારના પ્રોજેક્ટ જો તમારે તમારી કોલેજમાં કરવા હોય તો એ પણ આપણે કરી શકીએ છીએ। આપણે બધા જાણીએ છીએ MHRD દ્વારા આ આખા પ્રોજેક્ટની શરૂઆત કરવામાં આવી છે અને ફ્રી અને ઓપન સોર્સનો વધુમાં વધુ ઉપયોગ થાય એ હેતુથી આપણે આ કામ કરી રહ્યા છીએ। તો લેટ અસ લિસન ટુ મિસ્ટર તાદ્રશ એન્ડ નીલ અબાઉટ લિનક્સ એન્ડ ઉબુન્ટુ। તાદ્રશજી
थैंक यू सरवैया सर। फ्रेंड्स अगेन वी आर हियर फ्रॉम IIT बॉम्बे स्पोकन ट्यूटोरियल्स टीम विच इज़ अ प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट MHRD गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया अंडर अ टॉक टू टीचर प्रोग्राम विच इज़ अंडर NMEICT दैट इज नेशनल मिशन ऑन एजुकेशन थ्रू इन्फॉर्मेशन कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। एज सरवैया सर परफेक्टली सेड वी आर हियर टू स्टार्ट ऑफ यूज फ्री एंड ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर। The name suggests free. The softwares are totally free of cost. They are open source. That means it is you who are using these softwares. It is you who can change these softwares if you know how to change it. There is no licensing, no copyrights, nothing. So we use pirated softwares and like we are not aware of the copyright violations that we do, the licensing violations that we do. We need to be aware of these, and that's why the open source community comes into picture. It allows you to use free and open source software just like that. Download it from the web, take from a friend in a pen drive and use it. Because free and open source software believes that the knowledge is for sharing and not everything to be sold in the market, right? So it's free and open source software. Now in these tutorials that we teach you from here, we may not be able to spoon feed you each and everything. You might need to use Google for that. You might need to use some websites. You might need to scour through certain websites for that. Because in the interest of time, in 1 hour, we cannot teach you everything. But yes, there is an option. If you want to do these workshops, these tutorials of the MHRD project, Spoken Tutorials project in your college, just contact us. We are present on the Google groups for Sandhan Bisek, we are present on the Facebook page of Sandhan Bisek, and at the end of the tutorials, we'll also share our email IDs and contact numbers with you. We have been getting number of inquiries for the projects, number of workshops we are already doing in number of colleges. We invite more. Please do it. Now, I'd like to tell you where these workshops fit into it. we are not into any particular domain of workshops. We do not require everybody from engineering, from science, no. Commerce, arts, education students, everybody can do it. Because softwares, we all use it. Everybody of us use it. So, I sincerely request you to get into how, what and why of this project. I'll be sharing the website of the project for you towards the end of the lecture. Also, one more thing. Prerequisites. Personally, I hate this word, prerequisites. We don't require any prerequisites. Just, you know what a computer is? The monitor, the keyboard, the mouse, it's enough for us. You know the basic operating of the computer? That should be enough. Okay, so this was an overall idea of the project that I gave you. Let's start off. In the previous lecture, my friend Neil taught you installation of Ubuntu on Windows platform. Like you have Windows in your PCs, you want to use Linux also. You can use both of them. I use it. So when you need certain functionalities of Windows, switch over to Windows. When you need certain functionalities of Linux, switch over to Linux. But still, I request you to use Linux so far as possible. In previous lecture, we taught you the dual boot of Linux, Ubuntu with Windows. And yes, remember, the Ubuntu was 12.04 LTS. Again, LTS is long-term support. Certain versions of Ubuntu are not supported after a certain period of time. They don't update you. They don't allow you to use it. But 12.04 is LTS version, a long-term support, which will be allowed to use for infinity period of time. The forums will not stop, the support will not stop, and the updates will not stop. So I request you to use Ubuntu 12.04 only. Okay. Installation, you already learned in the previous section. I'll just repeat out the steps what were. You load a CD or a pen drive. You click next, you select the language, you select the keyboard layout, you select the drive, the hard disk drive partition in which you want to install Ubuntu. It will take some 30 to 40 minutes and you are done. Let me show you how Linux will look like, the Ubuntu 12.04 will look like after its installation. Just have a look at the computer screen. See, Ubuntu desktop, it says Ubuntu 12.04. This is something similar to what we see in Windows. It is very much similar to the bottom bar of the Windows, which we call taskbar. This is on the right. Now, it's so cool to use Linux. See this, how it opens up. This is also a kind of taskbar. So Windows taskbar is split into two, the top and the left. Let me tell you, using Ubuntu is very similar to using Windows, apart from certain changes which I'll mention as and when we come across them. There are similarities also which I'll mention as and when we come across them. Okay, let's start. First of all, let me tell you, there are two users of Linux. The one, when you install, you might remember we inserted a name. You usually insert your name, like I'll insert Tadrasha. You may insert any username. So that user is created during installation. Apart from this user, there is one more user, which is root, R-O-O-T, root user. Now, root user is something very similar to Windows administrator. It has all the privileges. It has all the rights that a user can do. You can change Windows files, you can change program files, everything you can change. So that is a root user in Ubuntu. The terminology and taxonomy changes, but the functionality should remain same, right? So it's a root user in Linux. And the user you create is your name, usually. So like I have a user Tadrasha. I'm currently logged into Tadrasha. I have put a password. I have entered the password and I have logged in. The screen that I just showed you is the actual Linux desktop. Now root user, if you are using root, I prefer you not to use it, because root user is very sensitive user in the Linux. If you changed a single file, that may cause errors in your Linux operating system. So please use the user that you created, the your named user. Don't be tempted to use root unless you are very well acquainted. So I sincerely request you to please use your username. Okay, first thing. Now what is advantages of Linux? The biggest advantage, the biggest, is it is not prone to viruses. in Windows, you need to use the antivirus system, you need to load the anti-malware and anti-spam and things and whatnot. Linux doesn't use all that. There are no cases of viruses, absolutely no cases in Linux. So like you can use any pen drive, any CD drive, floppies, though extinct these days, you can use them. Don't bother about viruses at all. No viruses need on Linux system. Now this is something, a great attraction for me. And that's why I switched from Windows to Linux. No viruses, no headaches. Save up on them. Okay? Fine. Now, though you use your username, I use Tadrasha, you might not be able to do each and everything, but yes, all the things that we need to use for a computer are possible. Right? So again, use your username. Don't be tempted to use the root. Okay? Fine. So now let's feel certain options of Windows. Let's scour across Linux. Sorry, Linux, not Windows. I missed out. Let's scour across Linux. Again, look at the computer screen I have. This is dash home, if you can read. In this, you can just type search. For example, I need, let's say, calculator. I will type, and there I have calculator. I click on calculator, and calculator comes up for me. A simple calculator, right? You can do 2 into 3 equals to 6, like that. This is a simple calculator, the first thing, right? How I did it? I go to dash home, I press the search, and I have calculator. Now one more important thing. When you open a program, it comes in the recent apps, right? It will show you again and again, so that you might not type calculator in the search box again. You have calculator over here. You can click it again, calculator will open. Okay, this is dash home. This is our my computer. In Windows, what we call my computer, Linux called it home. A home folder. So desktop, documents, downloads, music, pictures, videos, everything. This is your something similar to Windows Explorer. I'll close it. I will okay, minimize it. Let me minimize that. I have Firefox, Mozilla. Now Mozilla comes installed by default, you need not install it. Windows just give you Internet Explorer. Ubuntu will give you Mozilla. I'll close Mozilla. Now this is something LibreOffice. If you remember, the first lecture that we had on Sandhan was LibreOffice, right? And we told you that Ubuntu or almost all the Linux versions these days come installed with LibreOffice, like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, everything. So this is LibreOffice Writer, which is similar to MS Word. Okay, again, the next option on the computer screen is LibreOffice Calc. This is Microsoft Excel. Third is LibreOffice Impress. This is Microsoft PowerPoint. Now, next thing is something really important. It is Ubuntu Software Center. I'll click it. Let's see, it's open up. Ubuntu Software Center. Now, what is this? Right? You might have seen App Store of iTunes, Apple. You might have seen Google Play for Android apps. So, a kind of marketplace where you can download various softwares for Linux. So like for Windows, you need to search on the websites. You need to Google it out, which software, from where to download, how to install. This is a one place shopping stop for Linux Ubuntu. Ubuntu Software Center. Yeah, like you will see number of softwares that you can just click and install them. For example, I can take up, say, my calculator, some nice calculator I have. It is $0. It's free. Now, isn't it good? Almost all the software of Linux are officially free. Yes, of course, few of them you need to pay for, but most of them are officially free. Right? This is Ubuntu Software Center. I click on this installed tab, and it will show me what all softwares I actually have installed. I'll go for Office, say. Then I have this LibreOffice, Math, Impress, Calc, Writer. I showed you, I have installed into it, right? So this is Ubuntu Software Center, a one-stop shopping place for all the softwares of Ubuntu. Initially, in the previous versions of Ubuntu, anybody of you might have seen it, it is called Synaptic Package Manager. Something difficult, right? Synaptic Package Manager. This is Ubuntu Software Center, plain and simple. software center, a single center for all your softwares to be installed, whether installed or not, to purchase everything, all the help available over here. Now, as I mentioned, Synaptic Package Manager. Let me tell you what package actually means. What we call software in Windows is called package in Linux. Simple. Software in Windows is called package in Linux. They have accepted this taxonomy. We will call it package. Let's not call it software. We'll call it package. So like package manager, this is an evolved version of package manager, Ubuntu Software Center. I hope you got an idea what is a package. So like when you talk with your friends, I installed this package. Don't say I installed this software. I installed this package. Something good, something different, appealing. I find it appealing. Okay, so Ubuntu Software Center. I'll close this down. I hope you had an idea of this. Now this is Ubuntu 1. I will come to this slightly later, because this is something really cool, something really important, and you all would feel like using it. I'll come on it slightly later. Let me move to next. System settings. I'll click on system settings. Let's see what's open up. Yes, this is the system settings. Okay. This is Windows control panel. All of you might have seen control panel. This is Windows control panel, which is called system settings in Linux. Now, if you haven't seen control panel, don't panic. Okay? You are hardly going to use it for some different versions whatsoever. But then, don't bother. If you don't understand this, if you haven't seen Windows control panel, if you don't want to see system settings in Ubuntu, don't bother. It will work for you. But for example, let me see this appearance. I'll double click on appearance. Now that gives me change in desktop background. I can select, let's say, this. I don't like this. I want to restore the previous one. Okay. System settings. Right? Okay. So, a kind of background changing. I have a number of backgrounds by default installed and things like that. Themes. Various of themes. But no, I don't want to change my theme. I don't know how to use different things. I don't want to change it. Okay, I'll close it. I will click on quit in the taskbar. Yeah, it's closed. So system settings, a bit difficult if you are not so much computer savvy, but then otherwise, okay, fine. If you don't know it, fine, use Linux as you want. The last thing, the dustbin. The recycle bin of Windows, right? It is called trash, where we just put out all our files which we have deleted. In case we find out, no, this was not to be deleted, you go to trash and you find out the file you deleted, right click, restore. Okay, so this is recycle bin of Windows, which we call it trash. Okay, I'm back to my desktop. Now let me tell you some more features. This we almost went through this pane. Okay, there's also one more feature hidden over here. I'll show it. Yes, this one, workspaces. I'll show it to you at the end of the class, because this is something really cool, something really great. Okay, so we explore almost all of this, just Ubuntu one and this workspaces, two things left. We'll come to it slightly later. Okay, on the top you see a gear, settings. Like system settings, you can also see open system settings from here. We saw system settings over here. We can also open it from here. Right? Displays. Let's see what is displays. Ah, whether you need to connect to a projector, whether you need to connect your computer to a projector or to some other display like your TV. These TVs can be connected to the PCs. All those things. Okay. I'll not get into much detail of this because hardly useful. What's next? Updates available. I told you it will give updates of the operating system free and throughout your lifetime. So updates you can check from here. Printers. Have you connected any printer to your PCs or not and you want to use it? Log out, shut down. No, I won't do it. I'm still left. Okay. Tadrasha. You see Tadrasha over here? This is your username. What's it? I see a small tick mark beside Tadrash. That is, I'm currently logged in as Tadrash Shah. This is a user account, system settings, we won't go into detail of this. I'll quit. Time. Your speakers, you can control your speakers from right. I can increase and decrease volumes over here. This is a rhythm box. The Windows Media Player, what we call, is called rhythm box over here. Some nice name. I like this name. Rhythm box. Okay. Battery. Because this is my laptop, it will show me a battery. If you use a desktop, it won't show you a battery because you understand the reasons. Now this is a postcard, something like a envelope, not a postcard, sorry, envelope. Now this is something really great feature of Ubuntu, which it provides along with operating system, and you need not install any third party softwares, though packages in Linux, but you not install them. For example, chat. You can connect your Facebook account, your Gtalk, that is Gmail account, into it, and you can chat directly from your desktop. I haven't configured it yet, but you can simply enter your name, your nickname, you can click on connect and it will be connected. Simple. I'll show it to you some other time. Okay. Why is it? Close it. Close. Anyways. Next is a broadcast. Now this broadcast is something really great. I'll open it and show you why is it great. Yeah. Add new account for Twitter, Facebook, Identica. Twitter and Facebook, almost all of us use it. You can directly put your status updates to Twitter or Facebook from Ubuntu desktop. Something great, right? You need not log in. You did not open your Mozilla or Google Chrome, enter your username and password and just stuff like that. One click, type the message, done. Status update is there. Okay, there's a broadcast account. I'll close it. I'm just giving you an overview of the things. Because as I told you, we cannot spoon feed you within 1 hour of time. And this is something great. Mail. Right? Okay. The mail account setup. You enter your Gmail or Yahoo or Hotmail. This is Outlook. Outlook account over here. Enter your password. Click on continue. Your mail account is configured in Ubuntu. You can check your mail directly from Ubuntu. Again, no need to go to the browser, enter your passwords and log in and stuff like that. Right? So like you have your Twitter, you have your Facebook, you have your mail accounts, you have your chat accounts. Everything on Linux desktop. Cool and great. It is saving me so much of time. I'm in the middle of something, doing some work, and I feel no, I need to update this Facebook status. Do it right away. Okay, fine. Mail account setup I showed you. One more thing I like to show you in the same thing, envelope icon. Compose new message. You can check your mails. Click on compose new message, and you can put your account to blog, your mail account, anywhere, and you can send the message directly. I'll click on exit. I won't configure it now. Okay, some error I'm facing. Okay, I'll keep it closed. Cancel. What is this? I don't know. But anyways. Why isn't this closing down? Oh, closed. Anyways, I'll put it aside. Yeah, okay. When this has come up, let me tell you one feature I missed out over here, right? I told you we'll go to the workspaces slightly later. See, workspaces is like it. You have four desktops. What? Yes, four desktops you have in Linux. I'll show you. I'll go to workspaces. See. My screen is divided into four. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have this window open over here. It is not closing down. Okay. It is not. Oh, it went. Suppose I have, say, Ubuntu Software Center open in this window. Right. I want to open calculator. I'll go to workspaces. Go to another workspace. I have a blank desktop. Good, na? Ubuntu Software Center works in the background in another workspace. I have a new workspace over here. I'll open calculator, chalo. Okay, see, now I'll go to workspaces and you see, you just check what you see. Workspaces. Calculator open in one workspace, Ubuntu Software Center opened another and rest was still empty. Cool? You don't have this in Windows. Though there are certain softwares you can download and use it, but why to do that? Four of them. Four workspaces. Great. Okay, I want to go to Calcutta. I will just go to this workspace, click, it comes up. I'll close the calculator and I'll go to the previous workspace I had, in which I had opened Ubuntu Software Center. Here, I click it. Taking some time. Yeah, came up. Just a click, it will come up. I'll close it down. Now, one more thing. This Ubuntu 1. I told you I'll discuss it slightly later, right? Ubuntu 1. Install Ubuntu 1. Okay. Let me keep this as it is and let me tell you what Ubuntu 1 is. It is something really great. I use it every day. Each hour I use it. How? See, Ubuntu 1, you see something over here? Or something like cloud? You see something like cloud over here? What is this cloud about? Okay, I'll tell you. Ubuntu 1 is something, once you installed Ubuntu in your system, you will see one folder which will be named Ubuntu 1. Now, whatever you dump in that folder, it will directly go to your Ubuntu 1 account on the Ubuntu server. And you can access it from anywhere. Your phone.
Okay.
Hello? Hello? બોલો
મારો પ્રશ્ન એવો છે કે કમ્પ્યુટર આપણે સ્ટાર્ટ કરીએ છીએ ને સર
હા
તો નો સિગ્નલ એવો મેસેજ આવે છે મોનિટર ઉપર તો એનું શું કરવું
એનો અર્થ એવો થાય કે તમારું કોમ્પ્યુટર અને તમારું સીપીયુ જે હોય સીપીયુ હોય ને કોમ્પ્યુટરનું જે મોટો ડબ્બો હોય
જી સર
એ અને તમારું કોમ્પ્યુટરનું મોનિટર સરખું કનેક્ટ નથી થયું તમારું જે
એ તો કનેક્ટ જ હતો છતાં મેં ફરીથી બે ત્રણ ફેર મેં બધા પ્લગ જે એના પાછળના પ્લગ આવે તો એ કાઢી અને ફરીથી વ્યવસ્થિત રીતે ફિટ કરીને ફરીથી શરૂ કર્યું તો પણ આ જ પ્રોબ્લેમ બતાવે છે
તો પછી તમારું જે પોર્ટ હોય તમારું જે કેબલ હોય અથવા તમારા સીપી માં પોર્ટ હોય એ પોર્ટ માં કદાચ કોઈ ખામી હોય શકે તમે કોઈ કોમ્પ્યુટર એન્જિનિયર ને તમારે ત્યાં બોલાવીને બતાવી જુઓ જો તમે કાઢીને ફરી ફિટ કર્યો હોય છતાં ના આવતું હોય તો તમારા પોર્ટ માં કોઈ ખામી હોય એવું બની શકે ઓકે વી હેડ ધીસ કોલ નાઉ ઇન્સ્ટોલ ઉબુન્ટુ 1 ઓકે ઉબુન્ટુ 1 કમિંગ બેક ટુ ઉબુન્ટુ 1 અગેન ઉબુન્ટુ 1 ઇઝ whatever you dump in the Ubuntu 1 folder in your Linux, it will go to the Ubuntu server and you can access those files from anywhere. Your phone, you need a smartphone, right? Like Android phone or BlackBerry or iPhone. You can access it from your phone or from any other computer across the globe. You can access those files from anywhere. Just put those files into Ubuntu 1 folder. Let your computer be connected to the internet and your file will be automatically uploaded to the Ubuntu 1 server. You can access its files from anywhere. So now these days what I do, when I have to come down to lecture Sandhar, I don't carry my pen drive, my presentation, my pen drive. What I do, I put it on Ubuntu 1 server. I just copy paste it from my desktop to Ubuntu 1 folder. Give it some time, it is uploaded on Ubuntu 1 server. I come down to Sandhar, open my laptop, connect to internet and I download the file again. Simple. I don't carry pen drives these days. You can do it. Like you need to send a file more than 25 MB. Now this mail, this email, when you send an attachment in email, you can attach maximum 25 MB of file. You have 30 MB of file. What to do? Use Ubuntu 1, upload it on your Ubuntu 1 server, allow your friend to download it from his place. Simple. Actually, there are many other services like Ubuntu 1 these days. Google Drive. Have you seen Google Drive? If not, see it once. It is something really similar to Ubuntu 1. You install Google Drive in your computer. Whatever your files you put into Google Drive will directly go to Google server, and you can access it from anywhere, anywhere in the world. Your files remain there, secure, intact, and the way you want to organize them. If you have not seen, go once and see Google Drive. It gives you 5 GB of free space. 5 GB, pretty much space, right? Nobody needs more than 5 GB to transfer their files or just keep their files intact. I use both Ubuntu One and Google Drive left, right, and center, and I'm very happy with the performance. If you haven't seen Google Drive, install Google Drive in your Windows PC. You can also, yes, one more thing, you can also install Ubuntu One in your Linux operating system as well as in your Windows operating system, both of them. So like, you have one computer which is Linux in your office or say in your college, and you have another computer at your home which is Windows. Do nothing, upload your files in Ubuntu One folder in your college, go home and download it in your Windows operating system. Simple. Ubuntu One can be installed on Linux, on Windows, on your mobile phones, everywhere. Read more on Ubuntu One on Ubuntu website. Ubuntu website, we told you the previous time. Again, it is ubuntu.com, ubuntu.com. Go to Ubuntu One, see it, install it, try it, and explore the features. You'll be happy. I am very much happy with the service. Even Google Drive, just type Google Drive, see it, install it, try to use it. It's great. Okay. Now, a very important thing I'll just let you know. Notepad. We use Notepad very often in Windows. Where is Notepad in Ubuntu? Oh, I don't know. I'll see it. I'll go to dash home and I will type gedit. This is the name for Notepad. What we call Notepad in Windows is called gedit in Ubuntu. I see a text editor, click it, double click it, it will open a text editor for me. This is a notepad. I'll type that this is a lecture of Scope Sandhan from BISAG. Okay, right? I can save it. Oh, where would I save it? Let me save it on the desktop. On my desktop, I will name it. You can enter name over here, right? I will name it Scope Sandhan. I'll click on save. Okay, I'll close this. Yes, I see a text file on my desktop, Scope Sandhan. This is where you can use Notepad. What is the name of Notepad? Gedit. 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 What we call Notepad in Windows, we call it Gedit in Ubuntu. Okay. Now you see there are many features, or you can say many flavors. That will be a correct word. Flavors of Linux: Ubuntu, Fedora, Red Hat, OpenSUSE, Mint. Number of them. Ubuntu is the best one. I have experienced all of them. Ubuntu is the best. You call it support, you call how it looks and feels. Now it looks good, right? We just explored it. Ease of use, ease of installation, anything. Ubuntu is the best. Let me tell you, I'm not endorsing Ubuntu, but I'm just telling you that because I use Ubuntu, I'm very satisfied. I like you to use Ubuntu, right? Now this was something we just could cover in 1 hour for Ubuntu, but yes, we are towards the end of the lecture. As I told, let me share with you my and my friend Neil's email ID and contact number with you. I'll just write it down on my computer. You can just note it.
So regarding your any kind of queries,
for the spoken tutorial lectures or how to use this Ubuntu Linux, you can write us to, that is tadrash-106, that is tadrash-106 @yahoo.co.in, and my email ID is NEL_PA_25@yahoo.co.in. So we both request you that feel free to ask regarding any of your queries. We will be happier to help you, as we will come to know that you are trying these packages and this software at your home by yourself. So I kindly request you that regarding any of the queries, please just write us to any of the email. And you can also go to the site called the spokentutorial.org, that is spoken-tutorial, tutorial.org/new. That is our official website from the IIT Bombay Spoken Tutorial, where you can find this video lectures, where you can learn this free and open source softwares and packages. So where you can explore your knowledge, where you get all these video lectures, and you can appear for the online examinations also.
Okay friends, so we also invite you for any queries. Like, we had a phone call from Una. Any queries you have regarding spoken tutorials, we invite you. We can use this Google group on Sandhan as a forum for all the queries, for any questions you have. And again, we are getting tremendous response for these workshops in your college, because as I said, we cannot teach you each and every small thing in this stipulated time of 1 hour. You can organize these workshops at your colleges. They are free, absolutely free of cost, because it is being funded by MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India. The workshops are totally free of cost. We will send you the workshop kits, the CDs, the softwares, the handbooks, everything we'll send you. You can organize a workshop at your college. You need any help, we are here to help you. We can, if it is a workshop of many students, we can also come down and to your college and help you with conducting the workshops. But yes, we cannot do this every time, because if you have some 20 students, we cannot come down 100 kilometers or 200 kilometers for 20 students. But if you have a workshop of say 100 students together, we can definitely come down to your college. We would love to come down, right? So we invite you to conduct these workshops. And yes, the students are being certified by IIT Bombay. Now, you all know IIT Bombay is a premier institute of the country, the most premier institute of the country. You will get certificates, the students will be certified. For example, you have done workshop for Linux, your students will be certified for Linux from IIT Bombay. If you have done LibreOffice, we actually have n number of lesson plans. You can take up one, two or more. And throughout the workshop you conduct in your college, we are online with you through Skype. If you haven't seen Skype, we'll let you know. We will be online through Skype, through which we can video chat with each other to solve all your queries. And if there are many students from your colleges who are taking this workshop, we would love to come to your college and do the workshops, right? You can, any queries you have, and if you are interested in conducting this workshop, though, we from Sandhan and IIT Mumbai insist you to conduct these workshops, because it will be a great certification for students. It will be a great, you can say, opportunity for the colleges to conduct the workshops from IIT Bombay, big name. Please write us at the email ID which is provided. If you missed out on our email IDs, you can just post a query on sandhan_bisec@googlegroups.com. You all have it. And for any other queries, you can just mail us, call us, everything. Okay, so see you next Monday with something new, something better. Till then, me and Neil, bye bye.
Thank you.
Sandhan, All Gujarat Integrated Classroom.
Satellite na madhyam thi jodti kadi
એટલે સંધાન.